Hi, in this video, I am going to discuss about field effect transistors. Field effect transistors are also said to be FETs, FETs or FETs. If you consider a BC107 transistor or the general ordinary transistor, this transistor is a, or general ordinary transistors are said to be bipolar junction transistors. They are bipolar junction transistors. Now, why it is said to be bipolar junction transistors? Because here both electrons and holes will take part in the conduction process. Because of this, it is said to be bipolar junction transistor. Whereas if you consider FET, FET is a unipolar device, unipolar. That means only holes or electrons will take part, not both will take part. If the FET is n-channel FET, then there will be only electrons taking part in the conduction. Or if it is p-channel, then there will be only holes will be take part in the conduction process. Therefore, this is a unipolar device. Then, if you consider an ordinary transistor, then it is having mainly two disadvantages. The first one is input impedance of an ordinary transistor is very less. So the first point is input impedance is very low. Input impedance is very low. And the second one is the high noise level. The noise is very high. Noise is high in case of a BJT. And for FET, the input impedance is high. If you consider typical FET, the input impedance of an FET can be greater than 100 mega ohm. Also, FETs are less noisy. So these are the two advantages of a FET. And there are some other advantages also. The third advantage is the working of FET is very easy. The operation of FET is, the third advantage is, the operation of FET is very simple. Operation of FET is simple. Then next advantage for an FET is its construction, fabrication is very simple. If the fabrication is much easier than a BJT. So fabrication process is easier. Fabrication of FET. So we are talking about FET now from here. So these are the characteristics of FETs. Fabrication is easier. Then next is the area or the size of an FET is less than a BJT. Typically saying for an FET, the space is 1/5 space of a BJT. So it is less, it will consume less space. So you can have high density of FET on a chip. You can have more number of FET for a consider for a small area when you use FET to construct circuit. So it will take less space. Now the next point is, if you consider FET, FETs can be used as amplifiers, just as like our BJT or ordinary transistor. Also, FET can be used as resistors. It can be used as capacitors also. So you can have a circuit which is only consist of FETs, because FET can work as an amplifier, it can work as a capacitor, it can work as a resistor also. Okay, so it can work as amplifier, can amplify the signal, it can work as a resistor, it can work as a capacitor. Now because of these reasons, FETs are now very popular. Let me ask a question. What is the biggest difference between a field effect transistor and a bipolar junction transistor? If you consider a bipolar junction transistor, this is said to be a current controlled device. Whereas an FET is a voltage controlled device. So what is current control device? If you consider a BJT, ordinary transistor, output characteristics of the device are controlled by base current IB. The base current IB determines the output characteristics, not the base voltage VB. Whereas in case of FET, the output characteristics are determined by the voltage or the electric field applied, not by the current. Hence, this is said to be voltage controlled device. So, in a FET, the current conduction is either by electrons or holes, and it is controlled by means of the electric field applied between the gate electrode, between the gate electrode and the conducting channel of the device. Conducting channel. I will explain this point. What is gate electrode and conducting channel just now. So what I said is, in a JFET, the current conduction is either by electrons and holes, and it is controlled by means of the voltage applied between the gate electrode and the conducting channel of the device. Okay, so let us discuss about what is gate electrode and what is the conducting channel of the device. Now, before going to the details, let us discuss about the types of FETs. There are two types of FET. First one is JFET, and the second one is said to be MOSFET. JFET and MOSFET. Now, what is JFET? A JFET is junction field effect transistor. Junction field effect transistor, whereas a MOSFET is metal oxide semiconductor FET, semiconductor field effect transistor. So MOSFET means metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, and JFET is junction field effect transistor. Firstly, we will study about JFETs, and then we will go on to MOSFET. So for the time being, let us consider a JFET. So first, what is JFET? If you consider a JFET, it is a three terminal device, just like a transistor. So first point, this is a three terminal device, and we call these three terminals as source, drain and gate, just like our emitter, collector and base. Here I am naming it as source, drain and gate. In an ordinary transistor, we have emitter, base and collector. Here in FET, here we have source, drain and gate. Okay, now, so JFET is a three terminal semiconductor device, and where current conduction is taking place by only one carrier, that is electron or holes. Okay, so now let us discuss about the constructional details of a JFET. Constructional details. So first you have to consider a silicon bar. Now that bar can be P type or it can be N type. So I considered a P type silicon bar and an N type silicon bar. Now we have to form PN junction at the sides. So here I have a N region. Here also I have another N region. Now in the N type silicon bar, I have two P regions. So I have two P region. Then here this bar forms the conducting channel. Here this bar forms the conducting channel. So the bar forms the conducting channel for the charge carriers. Now if you consider the P-type silicon bar, then the charge carriers will be holes. whereas in the n-type silicon bar, the charge carriers will be electrons. And if the bar is p-type, then we call it as p-channel JFET. So this is p-channel JFET. So the channel is p-type, p-channel JFET, and this is n-channel JFET, n-channel JFET. Now, we have an electrode here and another electrode here, and from here you have to take another electrode, and these two N regions are internally connected. So I am connecting these two N regions, and this is said to be the drain D, drain. And now from here you have to take a connection. This is the source electrode, this is the drain electrode source, yes, and this from here you have gate electrode. These two interconnected terminal will form gate G. Now here similarly you have a connection from here to here, internally connected, and now here one electrode is placed here. Here you have other electrode. Again, this will be your drain D, and this will be source S, and from here you will take the gate electrode. So these are the three terminals of a JFET. The two PN junctions forming diodes in the sides at the sides are connected internally, and a common terminal is taken, and that forms the gate electrode. Other terminals are the drain and source electrodes. So a JFET has essentially three terminals: source, drain, and gate. So this is our N-channel JFET. First one is N-channel JFET, and this is your P-channel JFET. Here you have two, this is N-channel, and you have two P regions, and this terminal is said to be gate, and you have drain and source. Similarly for P-channel, you have P region, P-channel, two N regions, and this is the gate and drain and source terminal of the P-channel JFET. Now let us discuss about the JFET polarities, how to connect JFET in a circuit. So the topic now, next I am going to discuss about JFET polarities. JFET polarities. So let us consider a N-channel JFET. So let me consider an N-channel JFET. So this is my device. Now I have two P regions here. So the channel is N-channel, and these are the P regions. Now we have to make three electrodes. So this is our gate electrode G, and this is the drain electrode D, and the source electrode S. Now the input junction, that is the voltage between gate and source, is so biased with respect to, the voltage between gate is biased with respect to source, such that this input circuit is reverse biased. So since this is N region, I have to give a positive polarity here, and negative, positive, then negative. Now this is the input circuit is reverse biased. So the voltage between gate and source is such that the gate is reverse biased. This is the normal way of JFET connection. Now I have to give a voltage source voltage between drain and source. Now the drain is so biased with respect to source, such that the drain current ID flows from the source to drain. So drain current has to flow from source to drain. So I have to connect a negative polarity here, then positive, positive, negative, positive. Now since negative is connected to the source, the drain current ID will flow from source to drain through the channel. Through, this is the channel, through the channel source, the ID the drain current ID will flow from source to drain. Okay, so what are the points that I discussed? The first one, the input circuit, that is gate to source of the JFET is reverse biased. That means the device is having high input impedance. Second point, the drain is so biased with respect to the source such that drain current ID flows from source to the drain. Third point, in all JFET, the drain current ID will be equal to source current IS. The schematic symbol of a field effect transistor. I have shown the symbols of NPN and PNP transistors already. Now the first transistor is NPN transistor because the arrow mark here in the emitter is towards outside, and this is the symbol for PNP transistor. Now the symbol for an FET is very much familiar to the symbol for transistors. So here we will show a vertical line as a vertical line here. Now this vertical line in the symbol of FET actually represents the channel of the FET. So if I represent N channel JFET, then this is the N region. Then you will have the drain and source connected to the N region, and you will have gate also. So this represents the gate, this represents the drain and source. Now if I put the arrow mark in on the gate of the FET towards inside, then this will represent a N channel JFET. So the arrow mark is shown on the gate. Here we have the arrow mark in the emitter terminal. Okay, now if I represent the P channel JFET, again we have to start with the P channel vertical line, then drain and source connected to the channel, and you have gate. So this is gate, drain and source. Now the arrow mark will be towards the outside because now we have P channel JFET. If you consider the current in the base of the transistor, bipolar junction transistor, BJT transistor, the IB will be in the order of few microamperes. So IB will be in the order of microampere. Well, in the case of the FET, the current IG will be 0 ampere theoretically, and practically the current will be 1000 times smaller in the case of a FET, because now the resistance is in the input resistance is now very high. They are in the order of few mega ohms, so the current will be very much smaller, and this is one of the advantage of a FET, or I can say this is the difference between BJT and FET. Another distinction is if you consider the construction of an FET and a BJT. If you consider the BJT, then here you have two junctions for the charge carriers to pass. The charge carrier has to pass this region and also this region. So there is only first junction and there is second junction. Two junctions they have to pass. But here the charge carriers do not pass through any junction. So there is no junction as in an ordinary transistor in FET. So conduction is through an N-type or P-type semiconductor material. For this reason, the noise level in FET will be very small.